Hello and welcome to Reality Check. Are the forces of the BJP and the forces taking on the BJP a divided house? On one hand, a vote of no confidence that brought into sharp focus the opposition's need to set its house in order if they want to seriously take on the Modi Shah combined. On the other hand, the BJP too finding trouble within. Longtime ally the Shiv Sena now appearing to finally part ways with the BJP. And also senior leader Chandan Mitra walking out of the BJP and joining the Trinamool Congress. Well, Chandan Mitra joins us tonight on NDTV exclusively on his first interview after he left the BJP. Also joining us, Babul Supriyo, Minister of State, Heavy Industry, another senior leader of the BJP from West Bengal. Manish Tiwari, senior Congress leader, spokesperson, joining us as well. And here in the studio, of course, Aarti Jairath, senior journalist. Always a pleasure to have you. Chandan Mitra, let me just start with you. And just a very simple question at the outset. We are still processing this new avatar that you are joining us in. All the best, by the way, on this new path that you've chosen. But just to understand, Chandan Mitra, why exactly did you leave the BJP?
Thank you. Well, there was only one basic purpose. I realized over the last years that if one has contributed some way to the development and prosperity of Bengal, my home, that you have to choose the appropriate way, appropriate political way. And in that context, given the, I think, determined leadership of Chief Minister Mamata Banerjee, I thought the Trinamool Congress is the available vehicle to do service to the home state, and that's why, after considerable thought, I decided that I should join her, strengthen her, and try and do something for the betterment of the state.
No, you're saying you're joining for the betterment of West Bengal, but why is the BJP not able to provide that? Are you saying the BJP is a lost hope in West Bengal?
So that was asked your BJP. No, I don't think I think BJP has very cool kind of spokesperson and leader. They can answer the question. I am not here to run a campaign against the BJP. That's not the intention at all. I have spoken with one clear purpose in mind. I think the most effective vehicle available today is the Trinamool Congress and the leadership of Mamata. That's why
But Chandan Mitra, I just want to ask you that, you know, and I have to ask you this, and you would accept as a seasoned editor and journalist that your position is a complete U-turn. I just want to point out some of the things you've written and said about Mamata Banerjee. For example, in July of last year, you wrote, "It's widely believed that Ms. Mamata Banerjee's undisguised appeasement of minorities has emboldened hardcore elements amongst them to push the envelope further." You described Trinamool activists as worse than savages after they attacked a BJP activist in Hooghly. This was in 2014. You said the BJP was observing Uttan rising divas with today's rally. This was again in 2014. Mamata totally disoriented. She's observing Poton divas to mark her collapse. How can you then claim that she's going to usher in development?
Well, you're reading out from the trolls. You're reading out from the trolls. Who have been trolling me since day before yesterday. But look, I want to make one thing clear. As long as I was in the BJP, I was the senior leadership position, I was central observer for West Bengal, I contested an election on a BJP ticket from here in 2014, and therefore, I carried out the party's line. There's nothing new to it. So to hold that against me, yes, is, I think, very unfair, because that was my calling then. And I did what I think was only proper. I have now, after considerable thought, I have changed my position. And obviously, those views have changed. I think everybody has a right to change one's views depending on circumstances. And I have done.
Is it because simply you're disgruntled? You didn't get a good enough deal within the BJP, is what some would say.
Let them say what they want to say. I'm not going to rise to the bait. I mean, told, as I said, for the last 2-3 days. But no, that's not the case. I mean, BJP has given me a lot. They made me Rajya Sabha member twice. I have held important positions this central observer for Bengal, central observer for Odisha. I got a BJP ticket because this is Lok Sabha. So I have no grievance. I have no grievances that way. It's
okay.
Not proper that I am disgruntled. I am not disgruntled in the sense of being having a decision.
Okay, let me bring in Babul Supriyo, who until literally 48 hours ago was on the same side of the political divide as you, now on the other side. Babul Supriyo, what do you make of what Chandan Mitra is saying? He says that the best shot he has for the betterment of West Bengal is actually with the Trinamool Congress. Is this a big setback to you, Babul Supriyo?
Well, it's a setback to me personally. The politics is already there. He's such a close friend of mine, and I think in today's, you know, in the perspective of Bengal, the political fight is obviously has got into personal corridors, you know, where, you know, even I am not safe in Bengal, you're attacked every day. Forget, you know, leave apart the BJP party members who are actually tortured. So talking anything harsh about Chandanda is going to be extremely embarrassing for me. I would try to kind of beat around the bush to kind of put across one thing that, you know, with the kind of stature and the respect that Chandanda earned and has, you know, maintained in BJP, it probably would have, we would have loved to see him kind of, what should I say, you know, desert politics with the kind of, with saying that BJP cannot do anything in Bengal, rather than join Trinamool Congress, who has really been brutal, inhumanic, in his own words, barbaric, far from being anything to do with development.
But Babul Supriyo,
I think the fact that his connection is kind of breaking today, his mobile connection, his voice is kind of breaking today, we can't hear his sentences properly, is very, very ironical. It will really take him some time probably. I wish him all the best. He's really my one dada for whom I was driving down to Chuchura to sing last year when a huge storm came. And I, the pandals actually wore off. I never knew that this storm had some bearing that is going to have in the next year. I wish him all the
Babul,
best, but he's going to take some time to politically connect with the people in Bengal.
No,
but
no,
I have
that's
no
fine,
problem
that's
here
fine.
With his decision, and
look,
I respect that.
Okay,
respect
no, listen, that. You say that it's the Trinamool, which is barbaric and brutal and all of that, and you wish he was there.
In his voice,
side
in
by
his
side.
Language.
But what
in
does
this
say? No, no, but what is the fact that he's exited the BJP say about the BJP? This is being described by Rahul Gandhi as a sign that the BJP is a sinking ship. Amit Shah comes repeatedly to West Bengal,
all,
trying to increase your presence there, and yet someone like Chandan Mitra has walked out. What does this say about the BJP?
Well, it's his personal decision, boss. Don't embarrass me. I'm not going to say a single line strong against him. He's my dada. He remains that. Till 48 hours back, we spoke heart to heart in politics. We'll still speak heart to heart in politics. But if he needs to speak the harsh words,
I'm
in
not
talking
asking,
politics, we'll do that. But on a first exclusive interview, I will refrain from saying anything.
Okay, don't,
I'm very
don't,
junior.
Don't,
I'll
don't,
maintain that. And
okay,
please ask Rahul Gandhi to first take care of his ship. Is he even on the water? Is he even on the right vehicle? Maybe he needs a car,
okay,
not
don't
a ship.
Say anything
maybe
against
not,
the
even,
dada.
Not even on water. He's on hot,
Babul
hot sand.
Okay,
so
okay.
He needs to change his vehicle problem.
Okay, Babul Supriyo, don't speak anything.
I don't
say anything.
How he'll come, how...
Okay, Babul Supriyo, don't say anything against your dada, but at least say something about the BJP. If Shiv Sena is today saying they want no truck with the BJP, they didn't support you in the vote of confidence, they abstained. Now Chandan Mitra walks out. Isn't there a problem with the BJP's own house? We'll come to Rahul in a second. But what about your own house?
Srinivasan, you know, you obviously read the Mumbai newspapers. They're very clear analysis by people about why Shiv Sena is using a particular tone. Shiv Sena has always been the bigger elder brother to BJP in Maharashtra. I've stayed there for 25 years. I've seen I moved to Maharashtra in Mumbai in 92 just before the riots. So I've seen everything. Whether it's Balasaheb Thackeray, Uddhav Thackeray when he was not even in politics, Raj Thackeray, everything.
Right.
So I know inside out, I've sung for them so much. So I can tell you this much that BJP has already, Shiv Sena was always the elder brother of BJP in Maharashtra.
Today, okay, you're being very.
BJP has got almost twice the number of. Twice the number of seats that Shiv Sena has.
Okay,
they
fine.
Have their grudges. They're expressing it at times. But let them.
Let me,
they have still not walked away.
Okay,
so,
let me
so
just.
There
come
are a lot
to,
of mathematics involved, a lot of politics involved.
Okay,
in
fine.
That.
I would keep it to
you're
that.
You're saying
you know.
They are also Let's like not, the dada, the big Chandan brother in that. Maharashtra, Chandan Mitra, your dada in West Bengal.
Ghee Chandan Puruk.
Okay, fine. Let me just come to Manish Tiwari. But before that, I want to quickly understand from Chandan Mitra that you've changed your view, Chandan Mitra, about the Trinamool Congress and Mamata Banerjee. Now you say that she is going to usher in development. But have you changed your view on the Congress party and on Rahul Gandhi? Because of the fact that you've now crossed over. Are your views still the same? This is what you said about Rahul Gandhi recently. Okay. You said Rahul Gandhi's inability to emerge as a responsible and mature leader must be causing his party enormous heartburn. With every self goal he scores, the chance of his being accepted as an alternative to Narendra Modi get dimmer and dimmer. You still believe that?
Fair enough. This is my journalistic opinion. I'm an editor. I'm a journalist of more than 30 years standing. I have my points, but how publicly I will express these views will depend on what my party, namely the Trinamool Congress, decides. I think you must understand the predicament of people like me who are journalists as well as politicians. We are not entirely
no, but you wrote this
purveyors of
but Chandan Mitra, you and you wrote this in your right, you wrote this in your capacity as a BJP leader. I mean, you wrote that in your capacity as a BJP leader. But anyway.
I wrote that in my capacity as a journalist. Okay. But yes, also as a BJP member. And I mean, today, I'll have twice. But I can't say what the view will be.
Okay. You say you will now be a perhaps more circumspect. But Manish Tiwari, certainly one could turn around and say that the BJP's
but,
house is
but
perhaps.
Before that, let me just thank Babul for his very kind words. And I hope that we will remain very good friends for now, for the future.
Okay. Well, at least in your opening knock, he's you know, bowled a few softballs. I don't know if he'll do that the next time around. But Manish Tiwari, you know, one can certainly turn around and say Chandan Mitra has left the Shiv Sena's on the edge. But as Babul Supriyo says, is the house of the Congress also in order? I mean, in the vote of confidence, at the end of the day, it comes down to the numbers. The Congress took a drubbing. And yet, we have Rahul Gandhi, we are told, now clearly being projected as the prime ministerial candidate of the Congress party. Is that realistic?
The no confidence motion really reflects the reality of 2014 as Parliament was constituted. Since 2014, a lot of water has flowed down the bridge. And that's best if reflected in the fact that the BJP has lost the last 11 consecutive by-elections to the Lok Sabha in a row. The government has been unable to conduct a by-election in Anantnag for now almost 1 year. And so therefore, if you add up the totality of it, they might sort of be able to win a no-confidence motion because that's how the House stands as it was constituted in 2014.
Yes.
But when the elections are held 6 months or 1 year down the line,
you
will see a different reality because, you know, the country has moved on.
But
and the country is entirely sick of the new normal
Manish,
which the BJP has established, which is the politics of hate, the politics of fear, the politics of terror, the politics of intimidation, the politics of lynchings. I mean, before 2014, you recall Srinivasan doing a single debate on something called lynchings.
Okay,
you know,
Manish,
why
but
has
Manish
lynchings
Tiwari
become the new normal in this country since 2014?
Okay, fair enough.
Because
Manish,
the current government.
Okay, Manish Tiwari. No, but my point to you is that, okay, you may argue that the mood has changed. That could be debatable. But is Rahul Gandhi the right person to lead this supposed change? Will the other opposition parties accept his leadership?
Well, Srinivasan, the fact is that ultimately the result of 2019 is going to throw up a new reality. And in that new reality, if the Congress is the single largest party, then obviously the Congress party would get a chance to bat first, as it had happened in 2004 when the UPA had collectively elected Mrs. Sonia Gandhi as their leader and as their candidate for prime ministership. It's another matter that Mrs. Sonia Gandhi decided in her wisdom not to accept that offer. and then Dr. Manmohan Singh became Prime Minister, and the rest is history. But the fact is that even in 2004,
yeah,
since the Congress was the single largest party, it was invited to form the government.
Right.
The UPA was constructed, and the UPA unanimously chose Mrs. Sonia Gandhi as its leader.
Okay,
so
fine.
Let's wait for the reality of 2019 to manifest itself.
Okay.
And then, everything will fall into place.
Okay, Chandan Mitra, in your now new garb as a member of the Trinamool Congress, do you think Rahul Gandhi will be acceptable as the face of this non-BJP front, whatever form it takes shape? Or will that be a mistake?
You see, this is a hypothetical question, and I will endorse my good friend Mr. Manish Tiwari's point that if the Congress is the single largest party,
yes,
maybe he will be accepted. But it will have to be a collective decision. When you have coalition politics, there is a collective decision scope always. Like you just saw what happened in Karnataka. In Karnataka, the Congress was the larger party,
yeah,
but they abdicated in favor of the JDS.
No, you're saying if the Congress is single largest, then there's no problem with Rahul being the leader. You're saying if Congress is single largest, there's no problem with Rahul being the leader.
No, I haven't said that. Sorry, don't put words. I said if the Congress is single largest and then they say that Rahul Gandhi should be the leader, that will have much greater weight. And it's only at that stage does the decision about who should be the leader, that's the point it will come about.
Okay.
As of today, you can't say whether this is acceptable or not acceptable.
Okay.
Is the Congress largest, second largest? So why speculate? Let the elections happen, let the results come out, we'll see.
We'll see, sir. Chandan Mitra, Aarti Jarrett, you've been smiling as you've been watching Chandan bat in his new avatar. But what do you make of it? I mean, do you see both houses of both these parties in somewhat turbulence, or is it really much more the anti-BJP front, which is in disarray, and perhaps now at this time the CWC anointing Rahul? I mean, is that strategically wise?
Look, you know, the CWC is the Congress party. And I think you would expect the Congress party to say that Rahul will be our prime ministerial candidate and
sure,
our prime ministerial face.
Sure.
Just like I think Mayawati's people in the
we'll
BSP have said that Mayawati should be PM. I think we'll have to wait till the results come out before we can even see, decide or judge what's going to happen.
Right.
I personally don't feel that any anti-BJP front is going to project a single person as the leader.
Okay.
Because I don't think that the opposition wants to have a presidential contest,
okay,
against Narendra Modi. So I think they would prefer to have an aggregate of state elections.
Rather than just go one-to-one.
But
very quickly, what do you make of Chandan's sort of saying that, he's not committing to why he left the BJP. He's saying it's just for the betterment of West Bengal that he's chosen to switch sides. What's the real story in your view?
Well,
you've also known him for a long time.
Yeah, of course. And as he says, everybody is entitled to change their views. So I suppose, it fits in with that. But I think it's a commentary really on the state of the BJP in Bengal,
right,
and the prospects of the BJP in Bengal.
Right.
I mean, if Chandan wants to be involved in Bengal politics,
yeah,
I think today Trinamool Congress is the right place to be. Because
right,
I really don't think that the BJP is in a position to challenge Mamata Banerjee
despite all their efforts.
I don't know about the future, but as of today, I don't think they're in a position to challenge the BJP. So,
Babul Supriyo,
don't embarrass Chandanda with the question of as to Rahul Gandhi is going to be accepted by Trinamool Congress. He has to agree to what Mamata Didi said, and while she was carrying flowers to Sonia Ji's house, she had already said in Delhi.
You're saying don't embarrass Chandan Mitra by asking him for his position on Rahul Gandhi because he has to go with whatever Mamata Didi says. But of course, we don't know whether even Rahul Gandhi will be acceptable to Mamata Banerjee, in which case Chandan Mitra, you'll have less of a dilemma. But today, Manish Tiwari, on one hand, the BJP says that Rahul Gandhi is actually their best strategic weapon against Narendra Modi. But today, you talked about politics of hate of the BJP. You must have seen tweets, Manish Tiwari, by senior ministers of the BJP saying Rahul is a merchant of hate. Rahul is trying to rupture society. This was in response to Rahul Gandhi's tweet about the Alwar violence. Manish Tiwari.
Well, Srinivasan, who's rupturing society? Those people who have created this climate of fear, terror and intimidation,
yeah,
which emboldens every kind of lumpen, every kind of vigilante to take law into their own hands, which makes the police collusive in the whole exercise, where you know, you've brought a country to such a pass where the life of a cow is more important than the life of a human being. And if somebody points out these facts, you know, brings these facts or pulls no punches about articulating them, you know, you call him a merchant of hate. I mean, look within you. Where have you brought this country to? That a country which used to live in communal harmony, a country which used to pride itself of the best intersocial relations.
Yeah.
You know, you've come to a pass whereby lynchings have become a new normal. You know, from the south all the way up to the north, going into the northeast, every state, every front
Manish,
page of the newspaper.
Okay,
no, I'm sorry. It's not the normal.
The Home Ministry immediately intervened and said that this mobocracy needs to stop.
Okay,
the,
Manish, can I just ask?
Mr. Rahul Gandhi need not connect everything to politics. I understand you are in desperate need of votes. I understand you are in desperate need of, you know, Muslim votes. I know you're in desperate need of portraying Rahul Gandhi as the voice of the opposition, third, fourth, fifth front, whatever that is. But do not connect everything to politics. There are going to be policemen, irrespective of the political
but
party.
But Babu Supriyo,
they're going to have a cup of tea.
You cannot interrupt me
when I'm speaking. Let me make my point. You can always refute that.
Okay,
I'm not expecting you to agree with me. Be very clear.
Okay,
I'm not expecting you to agree with me.
What I'm
saying is, you're always going to have policemen who are going to make mistakes, who are going to make this act, what we're seeing, that they've had chai while the man was injured in the car. The Home Ministry, Rajnath Singh Ji, has gone in and asked for a report.
Yeah.
Please don't look everything as an opportunity to consolidate your vote bank.
Okay,
this is a callous attitude. You are going to have people in every party who are
Chandan
going to
Mitra.
Make callous statements. You cannot attribute everything to the,
Chandan
to the narrative
Mitra.
Of a party. I'm sorry,
but
that's not true.
Can I say something just to rebut Babul Supriyo? I didn't see much sympathy coming from the BJP in Rajasthan. I mean, except for the Home Minister of Rajasthan, who said that an investigation is on. Where have been the sympathetic statements from ministers, leaders, the Chief Minister of Rajasthan? I mean, a man has been lynched to death. Forget what the police did. The fact is that this man was brutally beaten by people who claim to be Gaurakshaks.
Right. The Chief Minister...
And nobody in Rajasthan has thought to make
Minister,
a sympathetic statement, in,
the Chief
you know, or gone to see the family anything.
Okay, Chandan Mitra...
Just because they're Muslims.
Chandan Mitra, just a second, Babu Sukriya. Chandan Mitra, last word.
Just one line. It could also be that, you know, maybe whatever we are seeing on TV has embarrassed the party there, and therefore they are going in for the criminal investigation instead of making statements.
Okay, fine.
Statements
Chandan
or
Mitra,
Twitter or Facebook posts.
Okay,
why did you take it?
At least you're admitting it's embarrassed the party. Chandan Mitra, do you think this business of who is really practicing the politics of hate? Let me ask you this question now in your Trinamool hat. Out of the two parties, do you think the BJP is practicing the politics of hate? Or is it, as they're alleging, the BJP is alleging the Congress? Because Mamata Banerjee is very clear on who it is.
But if you look at our contemporary history, I think every party is responsible in some way or the other.
No,
the
I'm
CPM
talking of right now.
Is perhaps the most party that we have seen in India. But right now, it's very difficult to judge. Because right now, the period is going on. How can you say? But I don't think that you can immediately pin the blame on anyone, but certainly the Congress, with its record of 1984 and a whole series of riots, can today turn around and claim innocence, but nor can the BJP. Everybody is guilty in some way or the other.
Okay.
So let's wait.
Okay.
History
All
will
right.
judge.
I understand it's a tricky tightrope for you at the moment. Chandan, but...
Chandanda, you remain a friend. Thanks for bringing in 84.
All right.
You remain a friend. Thanks for bringing in 84. That's very good. Thank you.
Okay, we're out
thank
of time.
Thank you so much.
We'll have to leave it there. Manish Tiwari, Chandan Mitra, Babul Supriyo, and Aarti Jairat. Thanks so much for joining us. That's it on Reality Check. Thanks so much for watching. Goodbye.